If we take soap solution, and we add turmeric to it, then it becomes red in color. It shows that it is a basic substance, right? So children, this was about natural indicators. Now we will move on towards salts. Salts are what? When an acid reacts with a base, then this is called a neutralization reaction. And in this reaction, water molecules are also released. Means water is also a byproduct. This reaction, children, I have told you in chapter 4 also, that when vinegar reacts with baking soda, then effervescence, you can see, means carbon dioxide gas is released. Water is also there. And one more thing is there, that salt is formed, and that salt is called sodium acetate. Okay? Reaction you have already written in the previous chapter. So this is neutralization reaction, means acid and base, they react together to form a salt, and water is also a byproduct. This is neutralization reaction. One example of it we can discuss, like I had shown you these tablets, digene tablets. When do we take? When we have excess acidity in stomach. So to neutralize that, this is taken because it has a base. Which base? Magnesium hydroxide. Properties of salts. Now, properties of salts, first is that salts are generally solid and they have high melting and boiling points. Second is solubility in water. Some salts are soluble in water, like our common salt NaCl, and some are insoluble in water, like your silver chloride. Water of crystallization. Now what is it? Whenever a solid means the salts are generally found in crystals form, and they have water molecules in them. These water molecules are actually the water of crystallization. And such salts are called hydrated salts. But when these water molecules are lost, maybe by heating, then these salts are called as anhydrous salts. Last about it.